Once upon a time, way out in Idaho, in a boom town called Warren by name, as rough and rowdy as any western camp, a game of poker was its claim to fame. The saloon was packed to its swinging doors. The tinny piano stood deserted and still. A hush fell over the smoky room as onlookers watched the two gamblers skill. Waiting for the winning hand to be played in this high-stakes poker game between the tall, sun-bronzed mining man and the pigtail Chinese sleight of frame. Charlie Bemis slid out four aces on the table. The Chinaman made a slight bow of defeat. "Bring the girl," he said in a guttural voice and low. The booty in the game, as the second Chinese rose quickly to his feet. He soon reappeared holding the trembling arm of a Chinese girl, 18 years young. Shipped from Canton in 1871, she had become the booty in the game this handsome gambler won. Charlie scratched his head and said with a hearty laugh, "Now I got you, I don't know what to do with you." Actually, if I weren't a lady, I would say what he really said, "What in the hell am I going to do with you?" But he soon discovered, I dare say, her full worth as she proved a companion, both loyal and true. Charlie led her through the door, that slender young lass, dressed in a yellow silk gown slit to the knee, sent to Warren that very same night, wife to the rich Chinese gambler-to-be. In Idaho's history, she was called China Polly, but for Charlie, she was an angel in disguise. She came to his rescue on that night he was shot, and without her help, he surely would have died. It was another poker game. His luck ran out, and he discovered what a treasure he had won. She put him on the back of a sturdy horse, and all their pursuers they did outrun. Polly tenderly nursed him back to good health, and under her kind and gentle care, his love for her blossomed and bloomed like a rose, and he realized with her his life he must share. He forsook the gambling tables once and for all to live a peaceful and respectable life, panning for gold at the mouth of Cripple Creek with a little Polly by his side, his Chinese wife.